Hi everyone, thank you so much for stopping by my YouTube channel. In today's video, I am going to demo one of my newest templates. Now this template is available for sale and this is not a tutorial on how to make it. If you're interested in purchasing it, I will leave a link in the description box so you can go ahead and get it. If you wanted to go ahead and design your own and you wanted some inspiration on how to structure things out, of course you're welcome to keep watching. But like I said before, this is not a tutorial, this is a template demo so you can see how this spreadsheet works. This is a simple budget spreadsheet. What that means is that you only have one sheet for 1 month. It's meant to be super easy to use. Right now we only have one tab or one sheet, but the beauty of this is that all you need to do for next month, for example September, I would just duplicate this tab or this sheet and then use it for the next month. All right, so let me give you an overview and then we'll put in some use case examples to see how it works. Right here, we have the month displayed, and this is created by just adding your start date and your end date. And so you double click to choose the dates. Here, I'm selecting August 1st and August 31st here. All right, so that's it. The next area would be to just jot down some financial goals that you have. So if you wanted to put some specific short-term goals specifically tied to this month, the next would be a financial overview. And this is a simple budget spreadsheet. So all we have are two basic buckets. And then we have sub-buckets. So what do I mean by that? You have the income, so money coming in, and then you have everything that's coming out of that income, and that includes savings, debt, bills, expenses, subscriptions. And then right here you have the sum of all of these, meaning that when you sum all of these up you get a total amount, and then right here is the difference. So your cash flow is the difference between your income and the sum of all of your expenses, but it's not really all expenses though, because that includes savings. So that's why I have sum of all categories here, because there's a sum of all of these buckets, which includes savings, which is technically not an expense, but it is how you are dividing up your income, and the cash flow will be what's left over. Now we do have two columns, so you can plan maybe the first of the month, you can plan what you want your budgets to look like, what you expect to receive from income, and all of the different amounts and what it actually turns out to be. Now, this table is meant to be read-only because all of this data is filled in from the other sections. What I've tried to do with this template is to put colors around the areas that shouldn't be touched. It's not always possible because I still have to think about the aesthetics of the template, but for the most part, a general, very general rule of thumb is if it does have this light color, you shouldn't be editing anything. So this should automatically be filled out based on the other sections that are completed. So when you start the month, all you're really doing is picking your month and then setting your financial goals. And then you're going to the different areas to set your budget and the actual amount. So let's start with income. With the income section, you have the option of putting up to 10 income sources, and that could be your main income source. It could be side hustles. It could be if you maybe had a garage sale, for example, or any type of income source you wanted to include. All you have to do is type it here. And this is the planning section. So this is where you put in what you expect, and this is where you put in what actually happened. So here is meant for you to type whatever you want. And you can, at the end of the month, type what actually happened, or during the course of the month. It doesn't have to be all the way at the end of the month, although it does make sense to complete this template at the end of the month, so you make sure that you've captured everything along the way. But of course, you can complete it as you go on with your month. Before we go down here, I will move up to the savings and sinking funds section. And again, this is free for you to type, so you would change the names to whatever your saving goal was, for example, or maybe your savings account if you don't have a specific goal that you're saving for. Maybe you're just saving for your emergency fund or your 3 to 6 month emergency fund or something of that nature. you would type it up here and how much you expect to save and how much you actually save. So this is why this is a simple budget spreadsheet. It's meant to be very straightforward. You're just typing in what you expect and what actually happened. The same goes for debt. And this is not the amount of debt. So this is not a debt tracking spreadsheet. I do have one, by the way, if you're interested in something else to track your debt. But what this is how much you expect to spend on that debt. So if you expect to pay $500 into your car loan or your auto loan, for example, you would type it up here. And then here you type up how much you actually paid into that loan. This doesn't represent the debt balance. It just tells you how much you want to spend to pay it down and how much you actually spent. I hope that makes sense. Moving on to the expense, this is one of the columns or the tables that's quite long because different people have different variations of expenses, obviously, and different categories. So this, you would notice that has a light color around it, and that's because the expense table is a little special. And it's special because, unlike the other ones, it's broken down into different categories, and you can have multiple entries into different categories, multiple different types of utilities, multiple different grocery trips or transportation. So all of that would be added up to one subcategory in your expense table. And because of that, there is a separate table that helps you sort of sum all of them. That being said, you do not change anything here or here. As you can see, we're following the same general rule because this is colored. The only thing you would edit when it comes to your expense is how much you expect to spend. So based on your different categories, which I'll show you how you add, because you do not add them here, you add them in a different section of this template. You put how much you expect to spend in each category, and this is automatically pulled in from the other table, which I'll go over after I'm done with the rest of the tables here. All right, the next table is the bill category, and it's just like the others. You type in the bill that you have to pay, okay, how much you expect to spend and how much you spend. And finally, we have subscriptions. And I did separate that because sometimes it's nice to see how much you're spending on just subscription services. Just like with the others, you would type in the specific subscriptions and then type in what you expect to spend and what you actually spend. Now, I think the first month of using this budget template would be the most time consuming because you have to type up every single category. But the beauty of that is, for the next month, all you have to do is copy the template. When you copy it, you're copying everything that you typed. So all you have to do is adjust any of the budgeted amounts and the actual amounts. But you wouldn't have to change the different names here and different categories because you've already done it once. So it saves you time as you move forward. Now, let's look at the graphs. The first graph is an illustration across the categories, what you expected and what actually happened. So how much you expected to save or put into your savings and how much you expected to put into debt and bills and etc., all of the different categories and what you see. The next is to show you in a donut chart what you allocate. Okay, so how much did you allocate for subscriptions versus expenses and the total amount in the middle. And the last graph is to show you what you actually spent. So you can visually compare the two as you go along or at the end of the month when you complete the entire table. Now let's actually go into the expense distribution. And this is probably where you would spend the most time anyway, because to be honest, your income, your debt, and bills, savings, those are more fixed and more predictable. What's going to vary month to month is your expense. And that's why we have a separate section for it. The expense category, starting with a graph that shows you the expense distribution and the expense tracking table and the expense category table. So this is self-explanatory. Once you input all of your entries, you can visualize the distribution here. So that way you can go through each section and see at a glance how much you're spending. Now, moving on to this area, this is where you would add your categories, okay? So when you're setting up for the first month, you can add your categories here. And you can add more categories as time goes on. So you don't have to worry about, okay, I have to get this right the first month. You can start with your main categories and then you can add more categories as you go along the month and, of course, the different months of the year. All you have to do is to type the name of the category. So maybe if you're not paying rent and you are paying a mortgage, for example, you can change that to mortgage and I'll show you how everything changes because it does change the entry area. So everything here is editable. You can delete it and change it to whatever you want. You cannot touch this area. Again, once you see the color, you know it is a cell that shouldn't be touched. And this is because the total amount is pulled into this table. Right here, the transaction area is where you do all of your inputting for your expenses. You set your categories here. You visualize here, but here is where you do all of the entering. So here it has this little invalid error message here. And that's because I changed the name from rent to mortgage. So rent no longer exists. But if I click on this arrow, you see that mortgage is now an option. So I can select that. So basically anything you change here is reflected here. That way you can select the right category that works for you. So if mortgage doesn't work for you, you could change it back to rent. Or if you're someone that's traveling and you don't have a permanent home, you can change it to Airbnb. You can change it to whatever works for you. Now, there are about 25 different categories. If you need more, you can certainly add. But then the more categories you have, the less useful it is. So it's better to group categories when it comes to categories that are very, very small instead of creating it its own separate category because then it's not as useful anymore when it comes to visualizing the data. So I limited it to 25, but it can be increased if you need to, but it's something that I don't obviously advise you to do. Now, to fill out this table, self-explanatory, you double click to select your dates, you type in the amount, and you select a category and you can type in whatever notes that apply to that expense transaction. Let's say, for example, the reason why we have things in category, I want to show you an illustration of how the table automatically sums up all of the transactions in the categories because you can have more than one transaction per month in a category, but it adds it all up for you. So I'll share an example of that. So let's say on the 9th of August, I did go grocery shopping. And let's say 2 days later on the 11th of August, I also go grocery shopping. I spent $40 this time. And I'll put it as groceries as well. And what you'd see is that 40 plus 30 is 70, so I paid $70 for groceries. And right here, it should say $70, okay? It adds it up automatically. And if you go all the way up here, oh yes, you can see by the way, it's changed to mortgage because we changed it from rent to mortgage. And groceries should now say $70. So what's nice about this is that it doesn't matter how many times you add an expense, it will add it up as long as it fits into that category. So if I wanted another for groceries at that category, groceries now should be $100 here and up here should be $100. So the expense transaction area is a little bit different because you can have multiple expenses that fit into each subcategory. And that's the reason why it has its own separate area. And it has basically up to 1,000 entries. So you have the room to enter as much as you can, but it limits it to these categories or these subcategories, I should say. And that also automatically gets imported into this area. So you don't really have to do anything here except for typing your budget. And that's basically it. This spreadsheet is perfect for someone that's just starting out with budgeting, that wants something straightforward, easy to use, might spend a little bit more time the first month setting things up, but as time goes on, all you're doing is copying the sheet to create a new month, which, by the way, all you need to do to create a new sheet would be to go down here to this place that says dashboard. By the way, you can rename this by clicking on this arrow. Click on that and you have the option to rename. So I could rename this August 2023. And then next month, what I could do is click on that same arrow, click on duplicate. Okay. It makes a copy of it. So now I have everything filled out. All I have to do is just change the amounts. And maybe I expect the amount to be the same. So maybe I'm just changing the actual amount, or maybe the expected might change as well. But everything is copied. So you don't have to write your income name again, or your debt name again, or your savings name again, or even your expense categories. All you have to do is delete all of the transactions here, and I'll show you how to do that, and adjust what needs to be adjusted. So let's say you've copied this table and now you have a whole bunch of entries that don't apply and you want to delete them all. One way to do this would be to click on the first cell, and now we're going to drag across and then down. Okay, you're just going to keep dragging until you've covered everything, and you can select a lot quickly by just scrolling all the way down, and the more you drag down, the faster it scrolls and it selects everything. So right now we've selected over 100 rows in this case, and all you have to do is just hit delete and it goes away. And once you hit delete, everything disappears, but don't panic. The graph disappears because there is nothing to categorize, right? But the categories don't disappear because they're still here. If you delete them, of course, then you have nothing. But if you don't delete this, everything stays intact. And of course, here, everything is zero because there's nothing in the table. So now all you have to do is let's add some expenses. So let's pretend we've moved on to a new month of September. And we'll just change the end date here to September 30th. So now we have September 2023. And now let's add some transactions. So we'll go to September 1st and let's say $850. We've paid our mortgage. Okay. Now the graph appears. Let's add a few more. Maybe on the 2nd, we went grocery shopping. We paid $30 for some groceries. And let's add on the same day, maybe we paid our electricity bill for $90. So that would be under utilities. So as you can see, the graph reappears. Okay, the amount starts appearing here. And once we go up to the table, you see it starts to fill out. And then you can rename it. So we'll just rename, and this would be September. And now you have your goals. You can delete this as well, uncheck the boxes. The same way, select everything and hit delete. Now it's a clean slate. You can type in the goals you have for September. And of course, change the amounts that need to be changed when it comes to budgeted or expected and the actual amounts. All right, so I hope this was somewhat helpful to you. And I hope that you found this informative, or maybe at least giving you some ideas if you are looking for ideas on how to create a budget spreadsheet in Google Sheets. And if you're interested in purchasing this, I'll leave a link to this spreadsheet in the description box section, so do check it out. If you have any questions about how to maybe create a certain part of this template, let me know in the comments section. And if there are enough comments, I will make a tutorial on how to create this spreadsheet. All right, so thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.